You know, my grandfather used to say, a person without memory is a person without humanity. And I think now I understand what he means. Today, people are further away from showing their capabilities. The machines are telling people what to do now. You know, my mom told a story of how giant companies like Google and Apple and Facebook all started with good intentions. Information, though, became so pervasive and hard to manage that in order to keep up with the most current data, people built memory-enhancing technologies. And today, when we look around, it's inescapable. Most people are one way or another linked with AI. I'm a believer in keeping memories to ourselves, using biological capabilities to understand, retain, and use data we come across every day. AI assistance might help to retain memories, but where does our identity go? Our memory is tied to our identity. If memory is only tied to us by these assistants, don't these assistants then start to shape our identity? Remembering through sharing, and through reading, through thinking about our past, that's what we're doing at the Human Ear Society. We're holding on to the past by referring back to archives of our relatives and analyzing and collecting artifacts from the past. The medal that you see here in the exhibition is from our archives. It's one of the broken skeletons that once was a piece of that held the bean together. When the city of Chicago reached out to our community to share this piece with the public, we were very excited. We hope they can create an experience that includes everyone in the bean experience.
After the industrial boom in the city around the 2050s, life was really competitive. There were so many talented and really educated people coming to the city for job opportunities. And all this competition combined with AI now being part of the workforce was just a lot. The job market wasn't great, there weren't a lot of opportunities, it felt really stagnant, I had to do something to get out kind of ahead of the competition. So I was looking for other ways, how can I be a little smarter, a little better, a little more efficient? Just what value could I sort of capture for me? And when I found Amazon was developing this cognitive data managing network, I was all about it. I wanted to be one of those first testers. So NeuralMe, Amazon's NeuralMe is extending our capabilities so much. I am not stressed out about learning, memorizing information. NeuralMe does it all for me. So this way I can keep up with AI. And honestly, I find myself collaborating with AI a lot. I feel really proud to be one of these first users of NeuralMe. So I also gotta say, Amazon's been awesome. They've been so supportive. We've had health check-ins, upgraded to VIP accounts, invited to private events. When there's anything new comes out, we get access to the new trials, zero complaints, zero complaints. I'll tell you a story, at one of these NeuralMe events, I got to experience the bean in life-size form. It was amazing. That was a side of Chicago I hadn't really seen before. I don't remember ever having seen it. I didn't know that it actually existed. And actually the way NeuralMe kind of messes with my memory, apparently there was no storage of that thing. I had never seen the bean in my past at all. But after the exhibition was over, my neighborhood voted to see more of these landmarks. It was just really, I think that's a really good idea. So I had to volunteer to join the Bean Memorial team as part of the NeuralMe's terms of service. But I was cool with that because it's a really worthy effort. It's the bean's back. It feels like it did 60 years ago. I'm just really proud to be part of this team. It's just great to bring back this landmark, which is so iconic to Chicago. And so I'm really proud of that.
So I'm the curator for Chicago West, Kanye's second daughter. I searched for one-of-a-kind artifacts and relics around the world for Miss West's collection. The West family has always had a strong connection to Chicago. Kanye West's childhood years and later career were spent in the city where he practiced music, design, art. Chicago had the strongest connection with her father's design practices in the city. Later, she became the design director of Yeezy and CEO of the company after her father's death. Mr. West and the rest of the West family value unique objects. The tweezers and the metal bowl that you see here today are made from metals from the original bean, bought from a private auction about 20 years ago. These objects were gifts to Miss Chicago from her father. The tweezers and the metal bowl were used as daily life objects in Miss West's early life. The metal bowl that used to sit in her office at Yeezy's is now worth $20 million. Even the tweezers is now worth $5 million. With the opening of the Bean Memorial, these objects are highly valued now. Miss West has donated her prized possessions to the memorial.